The penguins are amongst the most renowned groups of animals in the world. They only inhabit the southern regions of the planet. Some even call the polar regions home. The name penguin, however, was borrowed from another type of flightless bird. One that used to inhabit the opposite side of the globe. Pinguinus impennis, or the Great Auk, is a species of alcid that lived in the North Atlantic coastal waters, from Western Europe and Greenland to the coasts of Canada and the US. The Great Auk was widespread, but has now fallen into relative obscurity when they vanished from the North Atlantic shores in the 19th century. The Great Auk was the largest alcid that survived to the modern era, standing at 75 to 85 centimeters tall and weighed about 5 kilograms. It has a general physical resemblance to the penguins, despite not closely related. This painting shows variation in egg markings and seasonal and ontogenetic differences in plumage. Its behavior is not well known, since the Great Auk has never been described by modern scientists. Accounts by sailors are the primary source of information about the Great Auk's lifestyle. The Great Auk was reported to only leave the waters for land only to breed. They even roosted at the North Atlantic waters. They were quite rocky islands, far enough from the mainland to avoid predators such as polar bears and humans, but close enough to rich feeding areas, with sloping shorelines that provide easy access to the sea. These strict requirements meant that nesting sites are limited. It is believed that the Great Auk never had more than 20 breeding colonies. Only 7 localities of breeding colonies are known to man. They nested in extremely dense and social colonies and are believed to have mated for life. The pair laid one egg on bare rock and take turns incubating the egg for 6 weeks until the young hatched. The hatchling's appearance is not known, since there is no specimen that exists today, but it has been described as grey and downy. After 2-3 weeks, the parents left the nesting site but continued to care for their chicks until they fledged. The Great Auk is estimated to have had a maximum population in the millions. Since at least the 8th century, the Great Auk had been hunted on a significant scale, for food, and for its down feathers, which was used to make pillows. By the 16th century, the nesting colonies along the European side were nearly gone due to excessive hunting. In 1794, to protect its devastated population, the Great Britain banned the killing of this bird for its feathers. On the North American side, the Great Auks were still more abundant, but things weren't going particularly well for them either. American down collectors initially preferred eider down, but since the eiders were nearly driven to extinction in the 1770s, they switched to the Great Auk. The auks virtually disappeared from the North American coasts in the 1800s. The small remaining individuals in Europe still struggled to survive. As its rarity increased, so did its price. Rich Europeans wanted to buy Great Auk skins and eggs, as both were highly prized collectibles. The loss of a large number of Great Auk eggs to collections contributed to the extinction of the species. On the 3rd of June 1844, off the coast of Iceland, on LD, the last breeding pair was killed by fishermen while incubating an egg, upon a request from a merchant who wanted specimens. The two parents were strangled and the egg smashed, ending the last known breeding attempt of the Great Auk. The pair then became the last preserved specimens of the Great Auk. Unfortunately, today, the whereabouts of these skins are unclear. Following its extinction, the value of Great Auk specimens increased significantly. A specimen was bought in 1971 by the Icelandic Museum of Natural History for $21,600, which was the most expensive natural history specimen ever sold at that time. Today, 78 Great Auk skins and approximately 75 eggs remain. Some argued that the period of regional cooling in the 14th to 19th century, known as the Little Ice Age, have reduced the Great Auk's population. But recent evidence showed that even without the environmental threat, massive exploitation by humans alone could have been sufficient to cause its extinction. It is truly ironic, how the Europeans' interest to preserve the Great Auk within their personal collections instead accelerated the total disappearance of the bird from nature. The Great Auk was a unique animal, a one of its kind. With its extinction, the penguins no longer roam the icy waters of the North.